So this is for the emotional intelligence lovers out there in the audience, and we know that there are many of you, people who care enormously about emotional intelligence. I'd have to say that over the past 5 years or so, people have been sometimes a little confronted by what I've had to say about emotional intelligence. And really the reason for it, I mean, what we know about from research about emotional intelligence is that there are kind of two types of emotional intelligence tests. One is a self-report type of test, and the self-report type of emotional intelligence test seems to relate strongly to performance in areas such as leadership or customer service, anything that has a strong human component to it. There's only one problem with the tests of emotional intelligence, which are self-reports, and that's that they're heavily determined by personality. And so in the world of psychological research, the concept of emotional intelligence has been slightly toned down because it seems to be a different way of expressing personality. The second type of emotional intelligence tests is where you use ability-based emotional intelligence tests, because the sad part about self-report tests for emotional intelligence is that they seem to be incredibly fakeable from a recruitment point of view. And so people tend not to use them for recruitment purposes because everybody seems to come out with very favourable results. The ability-based emotional intelligence tests seem to measure something quite different from the self-report emotional intelligence tests and don't seem to relate to job performance in the way that the self-reports do. So we wanted to ask the question, is it possible to extract measures of emotional intelligence from a combination of a person's personality set and their value set? And in fact, the answer is that yes, you can. So you see up on the screen now, we've got the HEXACO personality model. Once more, people can see other videos that will tell them in greater detail about the HEXACO personality model. But the essence of the HEXACO is that it was developed by two fellows by the name of Lee and Ashton in 2005-2006. And in our view, it represents the best practice right now about how to explain human personality with these six factors that you see on the screen. Second is the Schwartz Personal Values Questionnaire. And this is the result of the research work from a fellow by the name of Shalom Schwartz, who is regarded as one of the world's leading researchers in the topic of values. And you'll see this diagram gives you the 10 components of Schwartz's Personal Values Questionnaire. And people, no matter which culture they live in, possess to a greater or lesser degree these values. Naturally, ethnic or national culture affects individual values, but people vary enormously from individual to individual. So the question that we want to ask is, could a combination of values and personality predict whether a person is likely to demonstrate the characteristic that's come to be known as emotional intelligence? So the third component of emotional intelligence, as identified by Austin and colleagues, is a thing called utilization of emotions. And utilization of emotions is the degree to which a person is able to use emotional information to make decisions, to determine the actions that they're likely to take. And so the question once more is, does personality and a person's value set predict this emotional intelligence component? And the answer is yes. So once more, a very significant regression model here, which is the predictive model that we're using. And you'll see the model summary, the percentage goes to around about 34% accuracy of prediction. And the correlation, of course, well over 0.5 once again. Now, at the bottom, you see the predictors of emotional intelligence, dependence. So people who are likely to be dependent on other people, who are likely to, in effect, bond with other people, are, in fact, more likely to be able to utilize emotional information. Sentimentality, people who are sentimental and empathize with other people are likely to be able to use that emotional intelligence information. And thirdly, social self-esteem, which suggests that people who feel comfortable in their own skin, they're not self-doubters, are likely to be able to use emotional information to make decisions better. Now, once you've got all of that, what does it mean? Well, ultimately, we know that emotional intelligence can be a predictor of things like success in customer service-oriented role. We know that it can be a predictor of success in roles such as leadership roles. So what we're providing here is an opportunity to take measures that we're already assessing people on. The vast majority of people that we psych test are, in fact, assessed on the HEXACO model of personality and the Schwartz Personal Values Questionnaire. And what we're providing clients with is an opportunity to get reports on these three emotional intelligence components as an additional service when they psych test. We've spoken to a number of clients about this, and not surprisingly, they're very interested in this. So the ultimate question for you is, can you make better and more accurate choices for people in people-orientated roles through using emotional intelligence information? Yes, you can, and you don't need to use extra tests. You can distill this information from the instruments which have been shown to be predictive of both success and failure in a range of other things. If you'd like to avail yourself of that service, then on this page you'll see a link which says click to buy. Click on that link and we'll show you how to get involved.